Apple support. Calls are recorded for evaluation to train personnel and improve contact center technologies.
Hello, thank you so much for holding and thank you for Apple support. Can I start off by asking for your first and last name, please?
Hi, my name is Ken Pillonel. So I have a problem with my AirPods. The charging case doesn't work anymore, so I think it's either there is a battery problem or the charging port doesn't work. And I was wondering if there's any way I could fix it.
No, usually we just replace the devices. Okay. It would cost more than it's worth to break it apart, to open it up and replace the battery. So it's more economical just to swap the case out.
That's not good, is it?
You really can't open those without breaking them. All right, I've got an idea. Alright, it doesn't look great. But before I make it better, let's look at what the real problem is. The shell of the AirPods case is fixed in place by those plastic teeth, and there is even some extra glue. Those things were designed to be unrepairable. To me, it's completely crazy that it's legal to sell something like that. We all know that batteries only last a couple of years, and each one of those cases has a battery in it. The first AirPod cases were sold in 2016, and well, a couple of years later is right now. So that means that as we speak, there is tens of millions of those that are ending up in landfills with no way to be repaired. And I'm not even talking about the buds themselves, which also have a battery. I've studied the case thoroughly and this is the best way to crack it open. It takes less than 5 minutes and you can use any cutting tool. Then once you're done repairing, you just slide in your freshly 3D printed frame. So essentially with that 3D part I've designed, a whole new world opens up for those AirPod cases. Now let's see if I can improve the finished quality. I've printed this part using an FDM printer, but an SLA printer will give us much better results because they allow for a substantially higher printing resolution. So I slice my 3D model for my Anycubic Photon Mono X printer, pour in some resin, and let it do its magic. It uses UV light to solidify the resin. On my last video, nobody noticed that the frame was 3D printed. The best part in all of this, I'm making it all open source. More info on that at the end of the video. So now repairs are finally possible for the AirPods case. We can give them a second life. Well, yes, partially. The replacement battery can be ordered online. But there is another part that can get damaged. The lightning port. Because it was so hard to get to before this video, you can't buy a replacement part anywhere. This means that the only way to replace it is to steal it in another AirPods case. Okay, well, I'm not done with that video. I need to do something about that. After creating the first USB-C iPhone in the world and putting it up on eBay, a lot of people wanted me to give the same treatment to the AirPods. I thought it was a pretty good idea and that it could potentially bring more attention to the EU ruling on that subject and its impact on electronic waste. If you're interested about that, I'll put in the description a few links to studies that were made and so you can check them out. The easy solution to make a USB-C mod would be to desolder the lightning connector and solder my circuit on the existing flex cable. But what's the point of that? It could be so much more. Imagine if I could create my own replacement part from scratch. There is not much going on here, just a few traces, some ESD protection and a connector. That connector though, I don't have a reference for it because schematics are not available anywhere. So here starts my quest to find out what that connector is. I hope it was worth it because I spent days looking for it. All right, this is it, I think I found it. I was this close to giving up, but then I made a desperate attempt. I just went on Google Images and started scrolling through for like 2 hours. And finally, I found what I was searching for. I've got the reference. It matches what I was searching for, the dimensions, everything. So we're good to go. So now I just need to adapt my existing USB-C circuit with a shape that fits inside the AirPods shell. I came up with this S shape. Simple trigonometry you learn in school comes super useful in those types of places. Once my circuit is done, I export it and upload it on the website of my friends over at PCBWay. I really like that I get pricing right away and the circuits they send me have always worked and been of high quality. The circuits arrived and they look gorgeous. For the price I paid, there is nobody else coming even close. Trust me, I did my research. I soldered all the components on it, and now we have only one thing missing. The custom replacement part is just flopping around and I need a way to fix it in place. Once again, I want to level up the quality of my work, so I looked at what Apple was doing with their connectors. Metallic supports. Interesting. Okay, I've never done that before, but it could be pretty cool. So I designed and ordered those parts that were laser cut in Spain. Then I found that the AirPods use 1.2 millimeter screws, so I ordered precision 1.2 millimeter nuts. To secure all the pieces together, I use a 3D printed guide. I got my hands on the best tool for the job, a precision puck welding machine from Lambert. It uses argon gas and high current to make very fine welding spots. So there you have it, a USB-C AirPods replacement part, from scratch. Alright, so you're probably thinking, okay Ken, looks pretty cool, but how can I get the same thing at home? Well, I've prepared three different ways for you to do that. So right when the video ends, you can head over to AirPodsDirtySecret.com and there you will find 1.
The links to the GitHub repo where you can download the 3D files for the frame and the Gerber files for the USB-C PCB. So that's useful if you want to make them yourself. 2, I'll be giving away a few kits for my other social media accounts. So you will find links to those as well. 3, if none of those work out for you, I'll also be taking email addresses for a potential sale of the frame and USB-C kit. That's it for today. Peace.